Welcome. Today we will discuss how train takes the turn using centrifugal force. Here I have shown a track, and this track is not in a straight line, it is bending. Suppose this is train, this is moving like this or moving like this. This and these two are wheels, and middle, this is axle. These two wheels are connected to each other using axles, and these two wheels are of same size. Now you see, if train moves here, so this distance is longer, this is longer distance. This distance is shorter distance. This means one wheel had to travel longer distance, another wheel had to travel shorter distance. How it is possible? That I will explain today. Now train turning depends upon three things: cone shape, wheel travel distance, and centrifugal force. What is cone shape? This shape, what I have shown, is cone shape. What is wheel travel distance? Suppose there are two wheels. One is smaller, this is smaller, this is bigger. And they are moving. So to take one full turn, if this wheel take this much distance, the bigger wheel will travel longer. Smaller is the wheel, it will travel less in one turn. Bigger the wheel, it will travel longer distance in one turn. Now comes centrifugal force. Now what is centrifugal force? FC? Suppose something is moving in a circle. Then a force will act outside the circle, this direction, which is called the centrifugal force, FC. That will be equal to mv square by r, where m is the mass of this item, v is the velocity of this item, and r is the radius of the circle. This is not necessary that if something moves in a circle, then only centrifugal force act. Suppose something is turning like this, then this turn acts like a circle, and if something is moving left side, then a force will be applied this direction. That is called the centrifugal force, FC. Just now I told three things: cone shape, wheel travel depending upon diameter or radius, and then third, centrifugal force. Now let us see how we will use all these three. Suppose this is track and train is going from this side and taking left turn. This train has two wheels, A and B, both are connected with axle. Because train is turning left, so this distance is longer, so A has to travel longer distance, B has to travel lesser distance. Now if you see from this side, wheel will look like this. This is wheel A. This is not flat. Train has both wheel cone shape. You will say, what is cone shape? See here. This is cone. If you remove this portion, then this looks like piece of cone shape. So we call cone shape wheel. Here This wheel is not flat, this is at angle, this is not like this, similarly here. So this is this wheel and this is B is this wheel. And this rail is touching this wheel at this point. So this is the radius. Depending upon this radius, this wheel will move the distance. Similarly this. Now both are equal, so both wheels will travel same distance in one turn. Now when train takes the left turn, a centrifugal force will act right side. So a centrifugal force will be acting in this direction. Because of centrifugal force, this both wheel will try to shift right side like this. This wheel will shift little right, this wheel also will shift little right. So this point, middle one, will move little right, and wheel which was here, touching rail here, will touch here, see here. Because this wheel has moved little right side. So earlier, wheel radius was looking this much. Because this has shifted right, wheel radius is now more. Earlier it was here, from here to here. Now from here to here. So this distance is more than this. So effective radius of this wheel has increased. Similarly in this case, this has shifted right side. Earlier it was here, from here to here. But because shifted right side, so now wheel is touching at this point. This radius is less. RV. Earlier it was R. Now right side is RA, which has increased. Left side is RV, which has decreased. So RA is more than RV because this also shifted, this also shifted. The more it shifts, the more radius will come. Now because radius of this wheel has increased, for the same turn, this wheel will travel longer and this will travel less distance because here radius is less. So when train takes the left turn, a centrifugal force will apply. Because of centrifugal force, both wheels will shift right side. This wheel, while shifting right side, effective radius will increase. Instead of here, it will come like this. In this left side wheel, when you shift right side, effective radius will reduce. Earlier it was here, now less. So because here radius is more, this wheel will travel longer. That is required. And because effective radius of this wheel is less now, it will travel shorter. So because of centrifugal force, this wheel become bigger, this wheel becomes little smaller. So it can move longer, it can move shorter. After it had turned, centrifugal force will disappear and this A and B will come in this position. Today this much only.